assumptions or you know, the expectations are set rightly. All right. With that, I am moving ahead, and here's a quick question for all of you, and I invite you to respond to this question by typing in the chat box, which is your favorite story from your childhood? We've all grown up hearing stories from our parents, from our grandparents, from our maybe neighbors. Since childhood, we've been hearing stories. So what is our favorite childhood story? Anyone would like to respond to this? Please use the chat box to respond. Okay, the hare and the tortoise is, yes, everyone's favorite. I see Chanda Mama, Akbar Birbal, Ugly Duckling, Ramayana, any war story. Okay, Mowgli. All right. Okay. Greedy Monkey. Wow, you're getting some good responses here. Mowgli, Akbar Birbal, Snow White. I have Chandrakanta, any Bhoot story, Mahabharata, Greedy Farmer, Shaktiman, Chanda Mama. Wow, amazing. So we all have these favorite stories of ours. Now, take a moment and reflect back. What
Excuse me?
Yes?
Excuse me. For me, chat window is disabled. I'm not able to type.
That's okay, ma'am. May I request, you know, we have about 140 odd participants. So I would request everybody to be on mute. If you're not able to participate, that's fine as well. You can always, so there should be a chat button on your screen. It should not be disabled because chat is something that is open for everyone.
I'm not able to use the chat. Sorry for interrupting. It says ask the team, ask. To you know, to join you as a team member, so probably the host has to do that. Hello.
Mute, ma'am.
Faraz. Taking the option out.
Yeah, we are having the backend team work on that. Just go on mute at the moment, please, everyone. There is somebody called Tejal. You can also go off the camera. Yep. Thank you. So, yeah, I think the backend team would work on this and hopefully it will get resolved for some of you. Because
for me also, same problem is coming.
Okay. Hello? Yeah.
It is fine. It is fine. I mean, this is a webinar, so let's respect other people as well. If we are not able to participate in a certain thing, let's just move ahead. Yeah. Thank you so much. So we've all grown up hearing stories, and as people, we like to watch, read, see, hear stories. Just before we got into this session, I had posted a question, and many of you responded to that about what is your favorite social media platform. Now, the idea behind asking that question was to also see where are we getting our stories from. At the end of the day, we live in a connected world, and social media platforms are actually nothing but ways and means of seeing, hearing other people's stories and telling our own stories. As human beings, we've been telling stories since ages. We've had stories being written on the caves. We've been had stories that we've been hearing handed over from ages, from one generation to the other. So we all tell stories all the time. Of course, it has some other meaning as well, that we tell stories when we don't want to go to the office and want to tell boss why we don't want to come. We make up stories. So yes, we keep telling stories all the time. Again, I'm inviting people to use the chat box, and I hope those of you who could not use it earlier would be able to use it. If you're not able to use it, that is fine. It's fine if you're not able to use it. Unfortunately, we will try and fix it at the back end. The team is working on that. So here's a question. In the chat box, type your all-time favorite movie this time. It could be a Hollywood movie or a Bollywood movie. However, you would also need to type, when you're typing the name, just put a, you know, like a dash in front of it and write in why is that your favorite movie? What makes it your favorite movie? What do you like about that particular movie? just type in the key in your responses. So I see somebody writing, for example, three idiots, but why is three idiots? So when you type in, don't enter. Maybe you will have to just type in the entire response, because I want to see typically the movie and why, the reason, both. So like, for example, somebody's put in Bhag Milkha Bhag, and because it is motivation. Veer Zara, because a great story about faithfulness. Is somebody written Baby's Day Out? It has a remake in my regional language. That's why. Very nice. Chak De India, because of the acting. The Intern, because of the belief in leadership. Three Idiots, because it's a fun to watch. Andaz Apna Apna. Okay. Money Heist. Great. So we're getting a lot of different movies. There is Lucy. We have Jumanji. We have Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara. Lots of movies. Now, stay with this. Have people who have unmuted themselves and have just joined. Can I request them? I have somebody called as Muzam Ali Ahmed. Can you please mute yourself? And we also have some background noise in terms of vibration, the phone vibrations coming in. Request you to please take care of it. So we have Snowpiercer, we have DDLJ, we have The Terminal, Zindagi Mein Na Milegi Dobara, For Friendship. Lots and lots of responses coming in. Wonderful. And if you see... Mr. Ali Ahmed, can I request you to please be on mute? All right. So we have lots of movies coming in, and we are going to try and see what makes up for a great story. The underlining, yes, while there could be acting, or there could be our favorite person acting that particular role, but you know, it could be the character, it could be the situation, it could be the whole theme behind the story, the way it was narrated. There are multiple things that can make a story great. So here's what we are going to do. We are going to try and create a story for ourselves. There's a quick little thing that we will need to do. We must have, all of us should have a pen and a paper for this. And on your screen, the next screen that you see, just follow the instructions. I'm here. I'll of course be giving you instructions for each slide. And we are going to create a small story, and let's see how that goes for us. So this is a generic structure for a story. So the first thing you need to do on your notepad or a sheet of paper is maybe on one sheet or two sheets, just draw five large boxes, rectangular boxes rather than squares. So just draw and name these five boxes as elements, setting, challenge, situation or scene, and action. These are the five boxes with five components, as we can call it, of the story, starting with element. And under elements, you can write 1, 2, 3, 4. In front of one, you can write you, and then just leave 2, 3, and 4 blank. Then we have the second box. The heading is setting. And the third box, which is challenge. The fourth box is for situation or scene. And the fifth box is for action. If you've done this, can you just quickly type a yes in the chat box so that I know most of you are here, and then we can move ahead. So Yashodhan and some of you have started typing in yes, that you are with me here. Excellent. Okay. So now this is the most crucial, critical bit of this whole story writing. The first box that you had, that is our step one, where you had written you and you had three other blanks. Now what we need to do here is the first part is you that you see either a boy or a girl. And then the second is a pet. Now pick up any pet for your story, any pet that you would like to be in this story with you. That is element number two of your story. Element number one is you yourself. Element number two is a pet. Element number three is any object that you would like to have with you in this story. An object could be as small as a hair clip to as big as probably a cricket bat or anything else that you could think of. Any object. Also identify the last element, that is the fourth element in your story, that is a superhero. And I say this superhero, or it could even be, I'm not being gender, I'm just using the word superhero as gender agnostic word. So feel free to pick up any superhero, or you can even be creative and create your own superhero, right? It need not necessarily be from the Hollywood movies or from the West. It could be an Indian superhero as well. So just get these elements in place. If you have these four elements in place, give me a yes in the chat box. Okay. May I request everyone to be on mute? I have somebody who's gone on off mute. All right. So now that you have this thing, there was a second box. On top of that box, we had something like a setting. Use that particular box in a few words. Just write what is the sort of the place, the situation. More than the situation, it's more of the era, the surrounding, or the theme of your story. Now, let me give a few examples here to help you out. You can say that the story is happening right now, right here in my house, or the story is happening 5,000 years from today. It is happening on a different planet, which has four suns instead of just one sun. Or it is happening in a place where there is no oxygen. Whatever, I mean, just go wild, go berserk, or you can go back in the history of time. Whatever that setting of the story, just mention that, in a few words in the second box. If you're done with this second step, we will move on to step number three.
Parag sir, can you please repeat the second step? I just missed it. Sorry.
It's there on the screen, sir.
Okay.
Yeah, it's there on the screen. Whatever I'm saying, I'm also showing it on the screen. Step number two is where we have to write. You can just mute yourself. May I request everyone to please mute themselves? All right. So the step number two is all the setting. Then we go to step three. Now, step three is typically about a challenge that the elements or the characters in the story face. Now, in this particular story, the character is you yourself. There is a pet, there is a superhero, and you are also carrying an object with you. So kind of, now that you have set a setting, just come up with some random challenge that you are facing that you want to overcome. It could be a personal challenge, it could be a social or a community challenge, or any kind of a challenge. You want to get from point A to point B, you want to save the day, you want to do something. Any challenge that you could think of, just mention that in box number three in a few words. And once you're done with this, just put a yes in the chat box. Okay, awesome. And we have people wishing each other happy birthday. There is Ashma who has her happy birthday. So wish you happy birthday, Ashma. Somebody called MTK is wishing you in the chat box. All right, step number four. Now, the challenge you have already put, now think of a situation in which you're trying to overcome this particular challenge. And given the setting and the sort of situation you are in, or you may find yourself, let's say you wanted to get from point A to point B, and that was the whole goal or the challenge that you were having. And while doing that, there is a certain scene or a situation that shows up, that there is a 12-headed monster or something, whatever you can think of. Think of one situation given so far whatever you have written. So you have a sense of what the characters are. You have a sense of what the setting of your story is in terms of which era and which what time period, etc. You have a sense of what is the challenge you might be facing. Now get a little granular and come up with a situation or a scene that you might find yourself in. Yeah. And if you are done with this particular step, this time around in the chat box, write OK. Either you can write OK, AY, or you can just put O and K so that I know that you have done this particular step. Okay, I've started getting few OKs here. People. So we are just trying to, fill in those boxes with few words at this point in time. We are not elaborating things really. And given the paucity of time, I'm going to move a little ahead. And this is sort of the last step or the last box, which is actions. Here you can, there are, if you see on the screen, there are a few questions that can help you understand how you accomplished or overcame the stated challenge to accomplish your goal. Maybe the superhero used certain superpowers. So define maybe what are these superpowers your superhero has. You were carrying a certain object with you. How did you use that particular object to overcome the challenge or accomplish your goal? You can also write about certain characteristics of your pet that helped you or came to your aid in time of need. So just write some of these things in box 5, which talks about actions. And once you're done with this, you could put a yes in the chat box. So in this particular step, as you see on the screen, we are talking about, let's say my superhero has the power to make all of us invisible, right? So I could write that we used the power of invisibility. I could say that I was carrying a watch with me, which was telling me time even in different dimensions. So I used that object. I could say something around the pet that was with me and how the pet helped me. So maybe I had a parrot with me, which could mimic various voices, and that was the parrot's ability. So yeah, if you're done with this, somebody's asking, could I use more space to write? Yes, please do. I mean, please think outside the box and write outside the box, if I may say. You're most welcome to do that. The boxes were more of placeholders for us to know that, yes, there are these 5 distinct components that we are working on a story. Great, I've started. Atul has said yes. Pratap said yes. Some Priyanka is saying done. We have some other people also saying yes, they have done with this step. Okay. So once we have these 5 steps completed, here's what we need to do. And I'm going to not, we are not going to do this now, given the time. But trust me, now you have a pretty good, I would say the backbone to create a story. You can weave all of these components in that I mentioned and tie them in together to actually come up with a story. Now, whenever we are talking about a story, we are trying to create something. A lot of times we as adults stop being creative. we start focusing on the laws of nature, the laws of physics, the laws of chemistry and everything. If you were to just give these components to a child, if you have a child at home or anyone younger at home, you give them these components and trust me, they will come up with a wonderful story. You can do that as a, since we are all in a lockdown and we have a weekend coming up, try and see if you give these components to various people, what all are the stories they can come up with. Maybe it's just an experiment you could do for fun at your home. But the idea is that when you have these five basic components of your story, then you can start spinning a story around it. And we will go a little deep into this as we move ahead. But I want us to quickly watch this particular video. It's an ad for a product. And we will talk about what happened in this particular ad. So I'm playing this particular video now. Please pay attention.
आजकल न्यूज़पेपर्स में कार्टून्स कौन पढ़ता है? I'm sorry, we have to let you go.
ये दो भाई दो का खाली डब्बा पूछ रहा है मुझसे. अब क्या? पेपर तो छप गया, कार्टून नहीं छपा. अब कैसे भरेंगे अपने दिन? क्या होगा रोज के रूटीन का? वो कॉफी लगाना और बस लग जाना. दुनिया से नजरें चुराते चुराते आइडियाज चुराना, बिना टिकट किसी की भी लाइफ में घुस जाना. खत्म हो गई वो रोज की जासूसी, वो रोज के झगड़े.
थिंक आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स ब्रो.
कभी ताने सुनना, कभी जूते खाना और कभी पत्थर. सच, कार्टून तो हम दोनों ही थे. रोज खाली लौटता था और मैं रोज अपनी पूरी लाइफ इसमें भर देता था. पर अब क्या? कॉफी का मग तो आज भी भरा है, कह रहा है चलो लग जाओ. अगर पेपर कार्टून के बिना छप सकता है तो कार्टून भी पेपर के बिना छपेगा. कार्टून और कार्टूनिस्ट खाली नहीं बैठ सकते, तो कॉफी लगाओ और बस लग जाओ.
ऑलराइट, सो इफ सम ऑफ यू वर हियर ऑन द कॉल, I invite you to type in the chat box, what was some of the elements in this particular ad that you observed? What was really happening? If you look at the storyline, how that went around a certain product, what were some of the key emotions that you experienced? Let's start with that. What were some of the emotions that you experienced? You can use the chat box. So change, breakthrough, being persistent, no one is ever idle, being limitless, emotions, expression, no matter what, life will go on, creativity, being innovative, perseverance, observation, all very wonderful, approach, current situation, being creative, persistent. Okay, right. Now, all of these emotions we experience, or these were some of the or out-of-box thinking people have written. Now, a lot of corporates and businesses are now using what we call as marketing using stories. Now, this is almost like a story, and this could be a story that many of us may be able to relate, given the situations where without any fault of ours, we may become redundant in a particular situation. So again, I thought it would be a beautiful example to share here through this particular ad. And we will come back to this and see what is it that this ad really did for us. When we look at, again, this is a very generic structure. If you look at a lot of stories that we like, or that we enjoy, they follow a certain generic pattern or a structure. You know, there is a ordinary person who gets a call to go on an adventure or do something. There is a refusal to that call. then the person meets a mentor. So I'm starting from the left side of your screen on the top and going anti-clockwise. The person meets some kind of a mentor or a guru along the way, crossing the first threshold when he or she realizes what are the, you know, sort of powers or what all he or she can achieve. Then there are certain tests, allies and enemies. Then there is an approach to the innermost cave. The innermost, deepest fears are overcome. Then the ordeal, the reward, certain roadblocks, resurrection, because the not always the hero succeeds at the first go. The hero might fail and then resurrect and return with an elixir. So usually a good story, a good movie is something that that is like a roller coaster. It has its ups and downs, right? Somebody actually in the chat box said, Vijay says that it reminded me it is my coffee time. Yes, Vijay, definitely go pick up your coffee. So yes, in a story, when we look at a story and you try to fit this particular generic structure, a lot of stories that we see around us follow more or less many of these steps in different formats. Even if it is a story of a social entrepreneur, even if it's a story of a fantasy kind, like that of Harry Potter, it kind of follows this pattern. So where does storytelling fit into business? Since stories are a huge part of our lives, and lately they have become all the more important in business as well. With the advent of the so-called, you know, entrepreneurial era, a lot of us have jumped into doing our own stuff, our own thing. And a business, be it small or big, is no longer just a business. In order to catch the attention of our customers, to catch their eyeballs, we need to always be able to tell a story. We need to be able to touch them with a story and, you know, need to tell. It's our own, right? So that's where storytelling as an art form or a skill is fast growing in the business world as well. Simply defining, storytelling, business storytelling especially, is nothing but when we have a personal story and we can attach a business meaning to it or a business message to it. That is what, simply put, business storytelling is. Business storytelling is about telling or presenting a brand to the public in a story-like narrative by using narrative techniques, like we just saw in the Nestle ad, Nescafe ad. It was like a story narrative where the brand was being presented. Business storytelling also brings the story of the business to life in the heads and hearts of the employees as well as customers. A lot of times when we are browsing through the social media, we come across the so-called brand building ads of a lot of organizations. They are using storytelling as a means to create brand awareness or to even occupy the mind space of their prospective customers. The social meaning of your business becomes visible and tangible. It enables your employees to identify with the business story. A lot of us are aware of how Infosys started in a small garage. The way that story has been making rounds is, you know, it kind of talks about the individual, it talks about the kind of culture the organization has. Or, you know, we have stories about the Tatas going around about their culture and how benevolent they are. So these are, again, please remember, these are also business stories which are used to the advantage of the particular business. So why should we use storytelling in business? Because it allows us to convey a business-related message, sells the brand in a more natural way, can trigger trust and more engagement, capability to foster customer loyalty, It is all about connecting with people, connecting people with the brand, a product, or a campaign. So storytelling is all around us. It is something that is quickly catching up with the business world. And it is a natural way for us to get our message across more easily across to people. And look at these statistics. Stories are remembered up to 20 times more than the facts alone. Now, when we heard the story of the crow and the crow was thirsty and he put the stones in the thing, we still remember that story. But, you know, I don't know if any of our grandparents ever told us how many number of stones that the crow put in and what was the capacity of the pot and all of that. So we remember stories better than just facts alone. When actually stories are aligned to the facts, they are remembered better, right? So for some of you, let me take a quick pause here and do a check. For some of you who joined early on, and there was a small story that I narrated at the beginning. How many eggs did the boy break in that story? Does anybody remember the number? The number of eggs that were broken? Okay, so we have somebody writing 10, somebody writing 8. Okay, 10, 2. Okay, so the number of eggs that were broken were 10. Yes, many of you have got that right. And you still remember it. That's a good thing. So yes, facts and, you know, the retention of statistics is slightly higher when we put it around stories, when we weave it around stories. So again, businesses are using storytelling to make presentations, to tell stories around certain facts. In fact, a lot of organizations these days, when they send their annual reports to their investors, it is almost like a magazine. It has a lot of stories in it. So how storytelling can be used in business? You know, at the end of the day, when we are interacting with people. We might have products, but products are bought by people. People make those decisions, including our own employees in the business. So our first customer are our employees. So stories actually help our own internal customers, that is employees, understand what the brand is, what the organization is all about. Each organization has a certain kind of a corporate culture, and these stories help shape that culture. When we hear stories about, let's say, an organization like Google, right? Even if we are not part of that particular organization, we have a certain image about that organization based on the stories we have heard from the employees, from other people in social forums. That's the power of telling stories, because it helps in building corporate culture and it increases employee performance. Stories can also be used to strike an emotional connection with our employees, with our customers. I'm sure many of us remember that at one point in time, when there was a controversy around Maggi noodles, they came up with their ads to, you know, tell their customers that there's nothing wrong with Maggi, and that empty number of tests that were done proved that Maggi always was great. So again, all of these ads had an emotional connect with the customers, and it creates an immediate response in the minds, which is memorable and shareable. So some of the applications of storytelling is managing knowledge, both implicit, explicit, and more importantly, tacit knowledge. When we say tacit knowledge, this is the knowledge we talk about, things like corporate culture or wisdom or certain actions that were taken. Those are the part of this tacit knowledge, and business storytelling has great application in doing that. Attracting talent. Again, stories help creating the brand value for an organization, which helps attract talent as well as retain talent. It presents data, creates brand value, brand awareness, and clarifies a certain stand that a particular organization might be taking in a social context. So these are some of the applications of business storytelling. And this could be in various forms. It could be in the forms of case studies, brochures, videos, white papers. Infographs are a great way to tell stories. It could be annual reports, articles. These could be some of the forms, or it could be stories could be even told through corporate ads, through speeches and talks. For example, TED Talks is a great place to tell business stories. It could be through town halls internally when, you know, there is a all hands meeting happening in a company, or there are some presentations, internal communications, social media. All of these are the various forms and mediums in which businesses can tell their stories. It is important for when we are doing business storytelling to remember that the purpose is very clear. You know, we have to engage with the audience, that is, speak to the people's emotion. And ideally, it should have only one message per story for it to stick with the audience. So these are some of the items I thought I will share with you around business storytelling. There is more to it. However, given the paucity of time, we may not be able to cover everything. However, I'm going to share this particular bit with you. Typically, when we talk about business storytelling, there are certain story archetypes. You know, there are certain patterns that you would see. There are stories which are coming of age, which show the experience and strength. There are some stories which are about overcoming obstacles. You know, there are stories which are about constant evolution or adaptability. And then there are stories of rebirth, stories of quest. So some of the examples that I could think of, and maybe from an ad perspective, because it's easier to, you know, relate to ad. So when we talk about stories about coming to an age, I could think about an ad of Titan Raga, which they had started, you know, airing a few months back. I think, I don't know if it is still on. It said, "Flaunt your flaw." So the whole ad campaign was about women having flaws and they flaunting it. So that to me is a coming of age kind of a storytelling, right? Then we have the next one, which is overcoming obstacles. I don't know, there was another campaign called hashtag fit to fight. This was a campaign carried out, a social experiment carried out by Reebok, where, you know, people were gathered and a woman who was bruised was shown, and reactions from people were taken. And most of the people thought the bruises the woman had was from either domestic violence or something similar. However, the fact was this woman was actually a martial art fighter, and the bruises were from a fight that she had with an opponent. Again, bringing out how, you know, we have certain stereotypes and how obstacles have to be overcome. Then there are certain story types, which are business story types, which is about proving adaptability. So Bajaj, again, I'm bringing that up, is launching their Chetak version in a completely new avatar. Now, if you've seen some of those ads of the new Bajaj Chetak, that is about adapting to the new market situation, an electric scooter instead of a fossil fuel driven scooter. Then there are, you know, reinforcement of trust. Again, the classic Maggi comeback ads are reinforcing trust. And you could have, okay, maybe a rebirth or a quest I would put together. After the recent, sometime back when Kerala went through a lot of problems owing to the floods and rains, they came up with a campaign. The Kerala Tourism came up with a campaign. I'm sure we recollect that. That to me is all about rebirth and about quest, and also maybe somewhere about overcoming obstacles. So if we see, stories are all around us. We cannot run away from stories. We constantly are watching and learning from stories. I am showing a few slides now that are sort of, I would say, resources that can help. I'm sure some of us are already aware of this, where, you know, we can use these resources to amp up our own creativity or our storytelling ability, because I'm sure even I am in the same boat. I also feel I'm not very creative, or I can't tell stories. However, it is a skill. It's a learnable skill that each one of us can pick up. And here are a few apps that we could probably install. There is an app called Storytel. The icon in the middle is called Booklet. Booklet is a wonderful app by a person, an Indian person called Amrut Deshmukh, based in Mumbai. What he does is every week he posts a book summary, but it is both in the audio as well as the visual or the text form. So highly encourage everyone to subscribe to Booklet. And then we, of course, have Audible, which are our audiobooks kind of a thing. Apart from this, and let me quickly also switch on the video before we end the call in some time. We also have certain books that I would recommend when we are talking about business storytelling. So these are a few books that you see on your screen that you could buy in hard copy format, or they would be in audiobook formats or even ebook formats, PDFs. So I found some of these them to be extremely helpful when it comes to business storytelling. And these are some interesting resources for the ones for those who are really wanting to amp their storytelling and business storytelling skills. There is something called as Rory Story Cubes. These are cubes that you get, and when you roll, it's like a dice. When you roll those dice, you get certain faces, as you can see on your screen, and you can start forming a story, you know, on the go, impromptu. So again, it helps in getting the creative juices flowing. We also have on Amazon, you should be able to find Kahani Cubes, which is similar to Rory Story Cubes. So Kahani Cubes are also available. And these two other icons that you see are more like an app. So the same thing that you can get with a Rory Story Cube or a Kahani Cube, you could also download these two apps called Dice Story, D-I-C-E Story, Dice Story. And again, it's a fun, these are fun apps where you just shake your mobile and a new configuration of nine such cubes will come onto the face of the mobile. And impromptu, you have to form a certain story using those nine cubes that you would see on the screen. So these are some interesting ways in which we can have our creative juices flowing that would help us becoming a better storyteller. I'm going to pause here and take any specific questions that might come up that you might have. Please use the chat box to type in your questions. And I request you to stay another 5 to 6 minutes because I have to make certain important announcements once we are done. So yes, please use the chat box in case you have any questions for me. I know we've kind of exceeded the time a little bit than I had scheduled, but this was extremely interesting session. Okay, so somebody wants to see the slide with the books. Here you go. And like I mentioned, this is just a mini session, a mini webinar to get you introduced to the topic of business storytelling and storytelling in general. We have an entire day program Vince's conducts on business storytelling, which deep dives into each of these components that we've been speaking about, how to really structure a certain story by going into each component in a little depth. So if you or your organization is interested in understanding and learning that more, feel free to get in touch with the team at Vince's. So I think most of the questions are around whether the slides would be shared or not. As I mentioned earlier, since this is a free webinar, what I would be sharing is something else. It is still a sort of a gist of what we have talked about, and I will be telling you what that is in just a moment if you stay till the end of the session, till the end of the webinar. Okay, so I have a question from Tushar. What are the most important elements you would say that makes a story credible? So I think the most important ingredient for the story to be credible is when you're telling a true story, when you're telling your own story. That is what makes it most credible, because that's when people will connect with you at an emotional level. I'm going to take probably one more. Any questions? I'm just quickly seeing. Okay, so okay, the question is around what is the name of the app which can be installed. So the name of the app is Story Dice, D-I-C-E, Story Dice. If you can go to a Google App Store or a Google Play Store or the Apple App Store, you could download the Story Dice app. Of course, there was somebody who said that storytelling for business presentation, any plans to have webinar around it? We may plan, if you have interest specifically around corporate presentations and storytelling on presentations, we can definitely arrange for a webinar on that. We are just past the 1 hour mark, another 2-3 minutes before we end the session. Thank you for staying on. We still have good 150 odd participants here. So these are some of the sessions we still have coming in over the next few weeks. Please feel free to go and register on vinces.com/register. I am going to request, so the giveaway that I have for all of you who stayed till the end, as well as who take a moment to respond to the feedback form, this is what I plan to share. What you see on the screen is a template of creating corporate stories, or it could even be your personal stories. This template I would be sharing with all those people who respond to the feedback that is coming to you at the end of the session. What I'm going to do is I'm going to paste the link of the feedback into the chat window, into the chat box. My request is, if you are unable to immediately go to the survey and take this survey, you may at least copy this particular link, keep it with you, complete the survey in the next 24 hours, so you get the benefit of receiving the template of making your own stories. This is the kind of template. It talks about the 4-step process in storytelling and story writing. The first step is about choosing your story. And there are 3 other steps. So you would get this PDF in your mail once you complete the feedback. I have pasted the feedback link. And with that, we come to an end of this particular webinar. It took us 1 hour and 3 minutes. I'm thankful for all the participants. Still, we have a good 125 odd participants or more still with us. Thank you so much. And yes, take a moment if you would like to post anything on the feedback in the chat window. Request you to please do that at this point in time. My next session is on Monday, which is on facilitation skills for leaders. That's the topic for the next session, as you can see here in the window. Fundamentals of facilitation for leaders. That's the entire topic, which we will be taking as the next mini webinar at 11 a.m. on 20th of April, Monday. Thank you so much for all the lovely feedback. Really appreciate all of you being here. Thank you. And Safale, over to you.
Thank you so much, Parag. It was really a wonderful session. And I would like to thank all of the participants for joining in the session. And I would just simply say that enjoy your weekends and be creative, stay safe, stay home, work today to create a better tomorrow. Thank you so much, all.
Thank you. Thank you all.